Okay, so let's make some tables out of some framing lumber from lumber yards and Home Depot, etc. So we're going to do, we're going to start with the legs. I like to use this Idaho Prime. This is not bad pine for what it is. You can only get it at the Home Depot, at least that I'm aware of. I sometimes find in my one lumber yard I go to, but typically they have the blonde pine, which is strictly for construction, and so it's not a major deal how nice and quality the wood is. But if you're making furniture, you want to try to find the best quality you can find, which, you know, it's not the greatest, but for pine, it's probably the heaviest, densest wood and has a nice grain. So there we cut the legs at 23 inches. Now we're going to get after we have our legs cut up, we're going to get our stretchers and aprons, our lengths here. And these are going to be, fronts and backs are going to be 15 inches since the legs are going to be facing outwards. And then sides are going to be 13 inches since we're going to have 2 inches for each leg. So you have to do the calculations. So 20 by 20 by 24 tables, I want to have the frames to be about 18 inches with the legs square. So I have about 1 to 2 inch overhang. So that's it. So now we're going to use a stop block again for the stretchers and aprons. We're going to cut these all so they're all identical cuts using the stop block. It makes easy work of this.
It's pretty rough. Pretty clean right now. So far just the miter saw and the planer, nothing else yet. No sanding, no router. So we're gonna do some pocket holes next. Okay, so let's figure out what side we want to drill into. So we'll take the least nice side, have the face. This one looks pretty good everywhere. Okay, so we're about two and a half hours in, I would say, and we're almost ready for assembly. Technically, I could probably assemble them, but I'd like to put a chamfer on the bottom of these, especially the bottom stretchers and aprons. I like to put a chamfer on the bottom of the tops, and on the top ones, I like to put them just on the bottom. So it just smooths out the edges a little bit, and all four sides of the legs will run a chamfer. All right, then we'll sand a little bit too before we assemble.
Okay, so once we're done running the chamfer on each piece, we're just going to run a rough sanding with 80 grit and get it prepared for assembly.
Okay, so everything's milled up. Sand it to 80 grit. Chamfer ran on the sides, bottoms and tops, all four sides of each leg. And pocket screw for the joinery. So now we're just going to get ready to build these frames. Only we still have to mill up bottom tops and upside down V's.
Okay, one thing for assembly, you want to make sure you have your spacers, your square, your spacers for your reveals, like I mentioned, your spacers for your bottom stretchers and aprons for your bottom shelves, and glue, pocket screws, and some clamps. Make sure when you glue and clamp these that everything stays square. Make sure the clamps are tight and not too tight. Make sure that your frame pieces are laying flat on a flat work surface. As you can see, I'm using the bottom spacers to set my, I guess we would call it your toe kick for your bottom stretchers and aprons. And this is going to be where your bottom shelf will be placed later after assembly is done.
Two tables completely framed out. So we're gonna put our upside down V's here, put some cleats down here for the bottom shelves, and we gotta mill up the bottom shelves and the top. About 15 should be fine. Put our little cleats here.
Okay, so I'm cutting up the cleat pieces here, and you'll see here as I start to mount these, I'm going to be using just some 18 gauge brad nails, 1.5 inch, and I'm just going to be using another little spacer here for my template. The spacer will be the thickness of the bottom shelves, so I know where to mount these. So if you have like little spacers available for all of your assemblies and have your cut list ready, if you're doing the same type of tables, these are the quick little tips that can help you expedite and get these orders out faster if you're building these on a consistent basis. Okay, so these upside down V's we're gonna mill up here. These are gonna be leftover 2x3s from the framing piece that we cut earlier. So they're partially milled already. So what we're gonna do, these are gonna be a preference, in other words. So we're gonna measure out roughly where the center is on our frames, and then we're going to cut our angle. These are going to be cut at about a 12 degree angle because I want to keep enough space so I can get my brad nailer in there to secure these. So this is all preference. I don't like to give an exact degree here because you can set them to 15, even roughly 20 degrees if you really want a tight letter V, I guess upside down V on your side pieces. But I like to have a little space. But like I said, this is all preference here. Okay, so note on this furniture, I am not claiming by any stretch of the imagination that I think this is fine furniture. I know it's not. This is rustic farmhouse, and that's what it's advertised. But does not mean that you don't have to take your time, be principled, and put the work in with this. So even though I could turn these tables out in probably 5 to 8 hours or quicker, honestly, especially if they're natural, I still have to follow the same steps as if this is walnut, oak, or maple tables. It's still the same steps, sometimes even more. Since the wood is not as nice, so sometimes you have to really mill it up even more to make it look like a nicer furniture. Even though some people want the rough tops and the dented tops and knots, I kind of don't like doing that. So I kind of try to make everything nice and smooth as much as possible, and that's how I run my business with this type of furniture. So as you see here, we're milling the tops and the bottom still, and we're just going to get it down to the final thickness. These tops. And then we're going to laminate these. So the tops are going to laminate with biscuits and glue. And we're going to be using clamps. We're going to be using parallel cabinet clamps and pipe clamps to glue these up and to put them together. But we're also going to be using the biscuits, so we don't have to hopefully use cauls here, depending on how these go together. And typically, if you use biscuits, if the wood's pretty straight and you mill it up correctly, you don't always need cauls. So keep that in mind. Okay, so to start finishing this order up here, we're going to cut the tops to the final length here with the track saw, and we're going to, while we have the biscuit joiner out, we're going to put our little slots in for our Z-clips. I always mount tops with Z-clips. So even though, like I said, this is rustic farmhouse furniture, it doesn't mean I'm just going to run some screws to the frame and put these on. So we're going to sand the tops down, get them nice and cleaned up. We're also going to run a chamfer on each edge, the bottoms and tops of these, And then we're going to finish. I'm not going to get into the finish of these because, to me, it's not important. And I really just did it for like filming me just spraying these with white paint. And that's what these are going to ultimately be at the end. They're going to be white with gray tops and bottom shelves. And I'm just using a weather gray stain and white paint to paint these. So while we're at it, we're going to just fill some of these knots in with some epoxy, with some black dyes. I think it looks good with the gray weather gray stain. So we're just going to fill a couple spots here and heat these up and really just get ready to do our final sanding on these and then our final assembly. Okay, so this order is pretty much done from an assembly standpoint. I still have to stain and paint. I'm going to be painting the frames white and this bottom and top shelves weather gray. I didn't really get into that. You know, I forgot the video part of it, and it's really not something that I really like the video because it's kind of, I don't know. I really don't like staining and painting these. So this is more just about assembly and how I assembled these tables. So now we're just going to mount the tabletops with the Z-clips, and we're just going to run some brad nails in for the bottom shelves. I sold the Z-clips. I'm just using the slots we cut with the biscuit joiner earlier. So this order is done. The client loved them, the tables. He's going to use them for his Airbnb. He's staging them down the beach, and they came out very nice. Thanks for watching.